The sun is really annoying. Okay, welcome to another episode. Hi, I'm Lupo. And in this episode, I want to talk a bit more about the solar system that we want to build on this mountain hut. The main purpose of this system is to have light in the hut. Because in the past, we had candles and those old school fuel-based, I don't know how it's called, this thing is, and those are also quite dangerous because everything is wood here. The hut is here for 100 years. And if we have a lot of different people here, visitors, and sometimes even alcohol might be also be involved. Okay, we don't say that. We don't say that. So forget about the alcohol. We also need electricity for the pump, for the water project. The idea is to have a PV. I changed the camera. So we want to put the solar panel somewhere here and then have the cables on this side, but I think shorter is better. So on this side, under the roof somewhere, and then go into the shed here because we want to have all the battery stuff and everything inside here. So battery, all the fuses, connections, everything here in a box. And then we can have cables in the hut again for all the lights in the hut, and also dig a canal here to have a cable to the system, to the pump system that we need for our water. So that's the main idea. And for everything else that I want to explain, how I want to build it, I think it's better to go down and then have on a whiteboard so that you can see how I want to build that, and then it's also easier for you. So I will ask my dog, she's quite asleep and enjoys the sun. So I will try to convince her to go down again. So I don't know what it is, but whenever we crossing this path, doggy jumps down there and starts digging. And I have no clue why. So now it's the first time that I will go down there and we'll have a look. We were already joking several times that maybe a dead body is buried. Let's see what it is. So, what is that? Let's see, it is a bone. Whatever it was. I don't know. Looks quite big. Like an ankle or something like that. Joints. Oh, I don't know, but yeah, it looks big. I think I just kick it away so that it's far away and she can't smell it, hopefully. So maybe you know that I'm a computer scientist, and therefore I always use the top-notch technology, and today I want to use a really new system that directly transfers my thinking into a visual representation that you can see, and that's called pen and paper. I want to quickly describe what my plan is and also what my reasoning was and how I started with the whole project. So at the beginning, I thought, okay, what do we have? What load do we have? What do I need at the end in the mountain hut? And of course, it's light that we need, and maybe a USB socket for some mobile phones, and maybe a 12 volt socket just for any other things. That was at the beginning my thought, really simple system. Later, I added my water pump because I need that for the filter system. And then I thought, okay, how many watts do I use here in this system? So with the USB, I would say 5 watts is max for a normal charger for a mobile phone. Lights, depends what lights you use, but a LED has usually 5 watts. Let's take a high number and say we have 50 watts that we use for the light, and the water pump has up to 120 watts. So then it depends how long you want to use, of course, the whole system. So let's say 10 hours, worst case for the lights, USB same, also 10 hours. And I think water pump is worst case 1 hour. Usually you don't need it that long, right? If you calculate then, so if you calculate 50 watts times 10 hours, you get 500 watt hours. Here 50 watt hours and here 120 watt hours. So in total we have 620, 670 watt hours that we have. So as you know, most of the batteries, they are specified in amp hours, so the capacity of the battery. So if you want to convert watt hours to amp hours, so we want to get amp hours at the end, we have to apply the equation power equals current times voltage. And if you want to get the current, we have power divided by voltage. So in this case, we have 670 watt hours divided by 12 volt. That is around 55 amp hours. So that's our key number that we have to consider for our battery. Now the question is, okay, what battery we want to use? So we have two options. We have lead acid, of course. And we have, for example, newer chemistries like lithium, iron, phosphate. And of course, you have advantages on both sides and disadvantages. Lead acid is definitely an advantage, the price. I think for 55 amp hours, you need around 100 amp hours lead acid, because you always need double the capacity of lead acid for this system. So let's say 110 amp hours, and here you need in theory just 55 amp hours. I think here you're around 120 euros. And with lithium iron phosphate, you're way higher, of course. So here, I guess you can get the cheap one for 400 euros, I think. The big advantage of lithium iron phosphate is that, of course, you can have a smaller one because you just have the exact capacity. Another big advantage is that you can cycle it away more often. So here with lead acid, we are talking about 500 cycles. Is that clear that this is cycles? Yeah, but doesn't matter. And here we are talking about, I would say, 3 to even up to 5K cycles. So in total, if you calculate that, the lifetime of the battery, it's definitely the cheaper options, lithium iron phosphate, if you consider the lifespan as well. Another big advantage is, especially for us, is this. Oh great, I was always bad with that. That's a fire, by the way. So this lithium iron phosphate can't catch fire, or almost impossible. So this is, of course, for our mountain hut, really good to have such a system that is really safe and that we can trust. If that is too expensive for you, there is still another option, that you build your own battery. And that's also what I want to do. So I decided to get a 120 amp hours battery for my system, lithium iron phosphate. And in total, it's below 500 euros. So it's double the capacity, but definitely not double the price if you build your own one. And I think you are also more flexible with your own battery system, and you will see it's quite easy to build. So that's how I started with the whole system. The next important question was the voltage. Do I want to start with my battery with 12 volt? I'm really confused with English and German. There's a Y battery. Okay, you can choose, of course, 12 volt, but you can also go up to 24 volt or even higher. It really depends. I decided to use a 12 volt system because I think it is just way easier. The maintenance is really simple. And if you don't have really high load here, then usually it's not a problem. If you have, for example, an inverter and you pull 1000 watts or 2000 watts, then I think a 12 volt system is not that suitable for your environment. But for me, it is around, I don't know, 200 watts max. A 12 volt system is perfect, I think. So if we are talking about the system, we also have a panel, of course, on the roof, and then we have in between a charge controller, and this charge controller is connected to your battery. That's a quite simple system. And then the controller or your battery depends on your controller. A lot of controllers have also connections for the load. The load is then connected to the controller. So that's a simplified schema of the whole system, but that's how I started. Then, of course, with the controller, there are tons of controllers out there, and you can do a lot of research with controllers. What I definitely did was to use a MPTT controller. The advantage of MPTT is I have a old solar panel that I got from a friend that was never in use. It's just a couple of years old, and it's around almost, or it is 40 volts and 185 watts, I guess. And here I have 12 volts. So that is not the same voltage, right? So the controller, the MPTT controller, converts the volt down to the 12 volts so that you can charge your battery. And the controller takes care of everything and manages everything. And MPTT is also future-proof, of course, because if I get another panel or a new panel or a second panel, I can still use the controller because the controller converts the voltage from this side to this side here. So that's convenient. And from this point on, I went into the details. One important thing that is missing here is safety. We haven't talked about safety, so this is really a simplified schema. But safety will be covered in my next video. So if you're interested, subscribe and see you in my next video.